for 6 months. Here we go. This is a lot of the things that we do. Eartha is an ambitious start. We want to do many great things here in this town. We want to start new things. As you can see, these are the main things that we do here. From vegetable oil trans-esterification into biodiesel to recyclables to food waste is where we're really going to make our stand. As we all know, policy is changing throughout the country. This is on a national level. As you can see, San Francisco, they're leading the way. But it's not just happening on the West Coast. It's happening in Atlanta. It's happening in North Carolina. It's going all around. And soon will happen here in Columbus. Next, we'll talk about local trends, and you'll see it everywhere. It happens every day. We've been fighting, I wouldn't say necessarily fighting, working with SWECO, which is the Solid Waste Authority of Central Ohio, to make food waste hauling in this city happen, not just for us, but other businesses that want to do this. This is the future. There's a lot of value left in organics that typically just make their way to a landfill. But not just with policy, we can also see with the market. You find it everywhere. In everything that you look at now, there are sustainable things that are brought up. But you can go to many restaurants and many places in the food service industry and you won't find it. And that is exactly what we're trying to do. We're trying to be a leader in this new revolution of food service. The main thing that we do is education. That is the start. We can't beat haulers at being haulers. We don't have the trucks. We don't have the working capital that they have. But we do have a plan, and we do have an organized method of attack for a lot of these things. And you'll see as we dive into this here in a little bit. Food waste is really why we're here today. This is happening in Columbus, Ohio. This is happening in Ohio. It's not happening necessarily anywhere else in the country. There are these, and I'll be a nerd, there are these beautiful waste energy plants being built around this state that take organic waste and they create energy out of it. They collect the methane gas that emits off of it as it decomposes. And this is one of our marketing pieces, I say our educational pieces. We want to make very visual, and you'll see this same sort of method used throughout. But food waste, the sky's the limit on this. They're happening in Ohio, they're not necessarily happening anywhere else in this country. They're in Europe, they're in Canada. Why are they not here? That is what we should be asking. We can retain value, and as you can see, it's not necessarily this simple, but I mean, we just plug it right in. It's an amazing process, and it's in reality so simple that we should have been doing it years ago. We create energy, and the remaining byproduct is organic soil. You can put meats, fats, oils, greases into all of this, and through a system of high pressure and heat, they kill all the bacteria that won't be killed in your backyard composter. The second main thing that we do are bioproducts. We operate a bioproduct distribution company here in this warehouse. You can't tell now, that stuff you might be sitting on. No, I'm just joking. We work with restaurants and food service of all shapes and sizes to start incorporating these products. These products are all plant-based. They're made out of corn, they're made out of bagasse, they're made out of natural unbleached paper. They're there, and they're not very prevalent today. What we want to do is create buying power programs for people to purchase this stuff at a great price. As you can see here, there's even a lot of misinformation in the food service industry about what these products really are. There's a huge difference between biodegradable and compostable. Biodegradable can't necessarily make its way into a composting facility, so what we do is we help people find that way. And as you can definitely see, one thing that we do is recycling also. Cardboard, as I heard mentioned earlier, we love cardboard, however cheesy that sounds. What we do is we take it here, we operate a small composting, I'm sorry, a small recycling facility where we take source-separated material and we process it in that baler over that way, and I get to press a button and smash stuff. It's every young man's dream. And we will take everything. We have a great group like Candles with the Calls over here to help us retain the most value that we can out of glass. The glass market is falling out, really, but they can come in and they can make the most out of it. One of the things that we will soon be working on here soon, as I said, is turning used vegetable oil, which is a nasty byproduct of every cooking process. We all love the fried food. We don't like the oil after it's done. We can take that here and we'll soon process it into biodiesel, which we'll use to fuel our fleet of trucks, in turn keeping operational costs down for everybody through deliveries. Again, it's not necessarily that simple, but I think you get a good mental picture. Grease goes in one side, biodiesel comes out the other. It's clean, it's natural burning, and it's 90% cheaper than diesel fuel today. One of the community programs and involvement programs that we really love is our book recycling and donation program. I don't know if you saw our guys over there trying to give everybody a big hug when you came in, but we work with a lot of schools, law firms, libraries, to take old textbooks, the ones that nobody reads anymore, the knowledge that's sort of surpassed. We take those and we recycle them. But all the books that I say still have a lot of love left to give, we take those, we store them here, and we give them to anybody that wants them. If you have some organizations that you know that want great children's books that are in great condition, you can talk to us and we can give those to you at no charge. And this is a big thing that I've learned from my mentors, especially Liz Lessner, is being a part of the community. I always say to do good is to get good. If you care about what's going on in your community, the community will care about you. We want to do new things here. We want to do exciting things here. And we need all of you to help push this at restaurants and make Columbus, Ohio a beacon in this industry right now, because I'm sure you've all heard, we have some of the worst recycling rates in this country. And that's shocking. We should all be shocked with that. But we have the opportunity and the chance to do something very special here right now and be the only city and the only state in the union that is doing this stuff. I'm already cut off. I could go for a lot longer. Thank you, everybody, for coming out and enjoying yourselves.